My name is Kees den Heijer, and today I'm going to tell something about NetCDF and OPeNDAP. The reason to share data is to transfer knowledge. Transferring knowledge in a sustainable way means that besides the data, we also must convey the meaning of the data. Many data formats don't do that by design, but NetCDF, Network Common Data Form, is explicitly designed to be structured and self-describing. The need for such a format arose in the early days of satellite observations by NASA. NetCDF is widely used in climatology, meteorology, and oceanography, but its design is generic enough to serve many other fields. A NetCDF file contains an arbitrary number of variables, dimensions, and attributes. Variables are arrays with zero or more dimensions. A scalar has zero dimensions, a vector has one, a matrix two, etc. The dimensions are variables in their own right, of dimension one. You can imagine them as the axis along a block of data. All variables have attributes or metadata. These attributes can have arbitrary names, but you will often see units for the physical units of measurements, along with other attributes, for example, about the error bounds of the measurement. Other attributes contain metadata at global file level, such as the author of the dataset and the coordinates of a measurement station. All these attributes contribute to the self-describing character of a NetCDF dataset. More features have been built into newer versions of NetCDF, but this is still the core around which everything revolves. Here is a list of properties of NetCDF as it describes itself on its website. I already mentioned self-describing, but especially for an archive that is supposed to last for many years, the last point archivable is also important. Old versions of NetCDF, even from the 1970s, will still be readable in the future. Compare that with common spreadsheet formats. When you have a format that allows data in an arbitrary number of dimensions, the number of data points can grow quickly. And indeed, many of the NetCDF files floating around are quite big and impractical to download. This is where OPeNDAP comes in. OPeNDAP is a protocol to communicate with data on a remote server. With this protocol, you can look at the structured metadata of a NetCDF dataset without actually downloading it as a whole. Then you can obtain just the part of the data that you need. This may be a particular slice of the data, of a certain variable, or a sample where you just get one out of every, say, 10 points to get a quick overview. But OPeNDAP can also do the reverse and aggregate a number of data sets so they can act as one. This can be handy with growing time series. Most popular programming languages have interfaces to work with NetCDF data. These plots are created with a small Python script, which is reading the data remotely via OPeNDAP. Two measurements of the beach elevation at the sand motor site on the Dutch coast are depicted. This shows how the coastline has flattened due to redistribution of the sand. In the code, you can see how a URL is referring to the NetCDF data. By choosing a different index in the time dimension, different time slices can be plotted. This shows in a nutshell how to read NetCDF with Python and visualize the data. Similar scripts can be made in other programming languages. This concludes the short introduction on the NetCDF file format and the OPeNDAP protocol to interact with NetCDF online. Thank you for watching.
We hope this video tutorial helps make the steps towards publishing your data in our repository as simple as possible. You can find more details about these and other topics on our FAQ webpage. For more information about how 4TU research data can support you, please visit our website or send us an email via researchdata@4tu.nl. To find fellow FIR data enthusiasts from your research discipline and to join our growing community of researchers and research data support professionals, please visit our community website.